My name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at FXBootcamp.com, and this is your news alert for Tuesday, June 10th, 2008. Let me first explain that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. We do not make trade recommendations. However, we do conduct technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. We assume that our newer Bootcamp members are trading on a demo account so that regardless of whether or not any particular trade plan is successful, they will certainly have an opportunity to learn and eventually trade their own live accounts for years to come, both profitably and independently. I've got a handful of news events on tomorrow's calendar that I'd like to address, so let's get right to it. During the London session, we'll see the latest monthly industrial production data for the United Kingdom. The headline figure from this report is an index, which represents the manufacturing output in that country over the recent three-month period. The number the market will be watching is the percent change in that manufacturing output for that three-month period compared to the output for the 3 months prior to that. Now, over the past 3 years, the percent change from this report has been as low as minus 0.8% and as high as positive 0.6%. Over the past 6 months, the average range in pips for the pound during the 3 hours following this release has been 64 pips, which makes this report a very respectable source of volatility for the British pound USD currency pair. Now, when it comes to news events, the stat we often monitor very closely is the difference between the forecast number and the actual number. We refer to this as the differential, and the larger this differential is, the greater the likelihood, generally speaking, of a move large enough to produce a profitable news scalp trade for us. While reviewing the historical data in NewsTrader Pro, which you now see, I've noticed that the news releases for this industrial production news, which have given us a differential of at least 0.3%, have been the ones that produced the best moves for the British pound USD currency pair. Although last month produced a differential of 0.4% on the three-minute chart you're seeing here, although last month's differential between actual and expected was 0.4%, the pound was ultimately stuck in a 30-pip range over 3 hours after the news. Now, that was discouraging, but it also wasn't totally surprising, because what happened prior to the news was this: the pound had already dropped some 170 pips down prior to the news release, including a very unusual drop of 90 pips in the 20 minutes leading up to the news. So I suspected the big move just before last month's release might have diminished the market's reaction to the news itself. Switching now to the industrial production news from early February, we see a different story. Let me show you that. On this occasion, the expected figure is a rise of 0.2%. The actual figure is a drop of 0.1%, yielding a differential of minus 0.3%. That sparked a drop of 40 pips during the first 8 minutes after the news, which you see here. If you entered a short trade somewhere in this area in here, on the 38.2% retracement level, somewhere in there, you grabbed at least 25 pips from that trade, especially if you would have put your stop somewhere up in here, and you've probably gotten stopped out somewhere in that area there. So a 25-pip profit, and hey, not bad. The news release in early November also produced a downward move on the pound. Let me show you that. In this case, same expected figure of 0.2% that we saw for the February release, only this time the actual figure is a drop of 0.4%, producing what was at the time the largest differential, in this case minus 0.6%, that was the largest differential in 11 months at that time. That produces a nice move down over the 40 minutes after the news. That was another move with about 30 pips of profit potential, again based on entry at the 38.2% retracement level somewhere up in here, and you took profit. Maybe you remember you got stopped out somewhere maybe in that area. So 25, 30 pips of profit there as well. Now, let me be clear. A smaller differential of, say, 0.2% can still move the pound in response to this industrial production news, can still move the pound to a degree which produces a profitable trade. What I'm seeing here is that the recent historical data simply suggests that a differential of at least 0.3% presents the best potential for moving the pound. Before the New York session starts, Mervyn King, I'm switching gears now, before the New York session session starts, Mervyn King, the governor of the Bank of England, will deliver a speech in London. Now, given the hawkish tones of speeches last week by Ben Bernanke, the president of the Federal Reserve, and Jean-Claude Trichet, president of the of European Central Bank, given the hawkish tones of speeches from those two central bankers and the market's response to those speeches, I would not ignore what King has to say tomorrow. If he sounds particularly hawkish, implying that the central bank's next move could be to raise rates to combat inflation in the United Kingdom, then that could certainly boost the pound. Moving forward into the New York session, we'll see trade balance news for the United States and for Canada. U.S. trade balance news can certainly move the market. Look at how the Euro-USD responded to this news release in mid-February. The expected trade balance was a minus $61.5 billion. The actual figure was minus $58.8 billion. That is better than expected, or less negative, suggesting dollar strength, which is down for the Euro-USD, and down she went. You could have been under your short trade during the pause in price after this retracement in here, so you're in somewhere at this level. And there, after what appears to be a 38.2% retracement of the move down, after the extension down, you could have locked in at least 15 pips, which is what we refer to at FX Bootcamp as minimal acceptable performance. And maybe you put your stop position, your stop just above this level here, this new swing high that was formed there, and the stop placement there might have locked you in about 25 pips of profit or somewhere close to that. But then you would have been stopped out during this spike up right there on that candle. These are 3-minute candles, by the way. So 15 to 25 pips, roughly, was there for the taking, depending on how you play this particular trade. Now, I should add that a significant differential between actual and expected does not guarantee a good move on the euro in response to this trade balance news. Let me show you last month as an example. Last month, we saw a differential greater than the one that I just showed you for February's release, and yet the euro was basically choppy after the news. One plausible reason for the lack of movement on that day on the euro was a theme of dollar weakness across the board during that particular New York session. In fact, oil futures rose, drew it to a new all-time high that day of nearly $126 per barrel. These days, by the way, these days the euro does not often drop while oil is rising. And finally, switching north from the United States to Canada, the Canadian trade balance news, which I referenced earlier, might take a back seat to the Bank of Canada's interest rate decision, which is due 30 minutes after the trade balance news. If that central bank does as the market expects and cuts its target rate by 25 basis points, then look to their rate statement for clues to their monetary policy moving forward. For example, if they follow the lead, I'm talking about the Bank of Canada, if they follow the lead of the Federal Reserve and hint at a rate pause out of a rising concern for inflation, that could boost the Canadian dollar, which means down for the dollar CAD. That's the what you now see is a 3-minute chart for the dollar CAD in response to the previous interest rate decision from the Bank of Canada. Now, be careful with that pair, though, because oil trading on NYMEX starts at the same time as the Bank of Canada news, and the movement of oil could either contribute to or wash out any effect of the bank's rate statement. By the way, oil is important because of the correlation between oil and the Canadian dollar. Anyway, good luck and good trading, everyone. My name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your news alert for Tuesday, June 10th, 2008.